Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Singing hallelujah. Yahweh's people dance for joy. Oh, come before the Lord and play for him on glad tambourines, and let your trumpet sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing hallelujah.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: petition to Our Lady for relief from cold cases, birthday blessings for baby Valen Menezes, Sarah Grace Andrade, Giselle Fernandez, Gail, Johan Gomes, Jocelyn Rodericks, Twinkle Pereira, John Menezes, good health of Julie, Manisha, Kunal, and Siobhan, Albertina Pinheiro, Perpetual Rodericks and family, birthday remembrance of Naqib Keshwani, for the souls of Tony D'Souza, Magdalena Pires, Ruby Gonzalez, Charlie and Anna Barrow, and Agnes Gopalan. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Every Eucharist which we celebrate is a reminder to us of God's love. As we come today to this Eucharistic table, let us seek God's pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, strengthen those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, I wish you would bear with me in a little foolishness. Do bear with me, for I feel a divine jealousy for you, since I betrothed you to one husband, to present you as a pure virgin to Christ. But I am afraid that as the serpent deceived Eve by his cunning, your thoughts will be led astray from a sincere and pure devotion to Christ. For if someone comes and proclaims another Jesus than the one we proclaim, or if you receive a different spirit from the one you received, or if you accept a different gospel from the one you accepted, you put up with it readily enough. Indeed, I consider that I am not in the least inferior to these super apostles, Even if I am unskilled in speaking, I am not so in knowledge. Indeed, in every way, we have made this plain to you in all things. Or did I commit a sin in humbling myself so that you might be exalted? Because I preached God's gospel to you free of charge. I robbed other churches by accepting support from them in order to serve you. And when I was with you and was in need, I did not burden anyone, for the brothers who came from Macedonia supplied my need. So I refrained and will refrain from burdening you in any way. As the truth of Christ is in me, this boasting of mine will not be silenced in the regions of Achaia. And why? Because I do not love you? God knows I do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, the Lord's handiwork is justice and truth. Kindly listen to the tune.
The Lord's handiwork is justice and truth. The Lord's handiwork is justice and truth.
I will praise the Lord with all my heart in the meeting of the just and the assembly. Great are the works of the Lord, to be pondered by all who delight in them.
The Lord's handiwork is justice and truth.
Majestic and glorious his work. His justice stands firm forever. He has given us a memorial of his wonders. The Lord is gracious and merciful.
The Lord's handiwork is justice and truth. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
You have received the spirit of adoption as sons, by whom we cry, Abba, Father.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, when you pray, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do. For they think that they will be heard for their many words. Do not be like them. For your Father knows what you need before you ask. Pray then like this. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For if you forgive others their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
The apostles of our Lord were always in awe of him. And we know that wherever the Lord went, he was able to bring peace and joy to the lives of everyone who listened to him, everyone who came to him for help. Our Lord went about healing people. And as a result, there were many who came to the Lord to be touched, to be prayed over, to be blessed. And one thing that was very evident was that the apostles saw the Lord pray. He spent long hours in prayer. And anyone would have said that since he is the Son of God, he did not really require to pray. But the Lord teaches us one thing, that God, who is our Father, is someone we must be constantly addressing our prayer to. And it is a prayer of pure abandonment, that we surrender everything to this God who knows. And once again, we hear these words both in our first reading as well as the gospel, that God knows. So what is this prayer that we are talking about? What is the dynamics? So while we pray, we are surrendering to God who knows. And we who pray are waiting for the Lord to guide us. So while we praise Him for all His blessings, we are also seeking from the Lord many requirements of our day-to-day lives. It could be bread, food, employment, love in our relationships. It can be anything. But this communication, this dynamic that we have in prayer, is indeed a dynamic like two lovers. In the beginning, there is a lot of talk, a lot of discussion. Gradually, there is an intimacy that is reached. And we find, therefore, that in this intimate prayer of the Our Father, or the Lord's Prayer, this total surrender is evident. And there is also what we call the action plan. And what is this action plan? It centers around forgiveness. That is something very difficult. But the Lord is telling us, when we pray, our hearts must be open, our lives must be empty, we must not harbor any sort of resentments and anger and animosity, and we do this by forgiving the people who have hurt us. And what is the necessity? Because forgiveness means that we are ready to let go and allow God to reside in us, and also allow God to do what He thinks is best for us. So each and every day of our lives, when we pray, whether it's the Our Father or any other structured prayer, we must always remember this, that our prayer is a prayer of complete surrender, of grace to God, and also our readiness to do whatever He wills of us. And in this prayer we find the necessity to forgive. So while we pray for the strength to forgive, let us also pray to the Lord that in this surrender that we make, He will always guide our journeys, that He will always be the light for us, that even in moments of darkness and despair, our lives will be illumined because of His presence in our lives. Amen.
Accept, Almighty Father, these gifts of prayer and wine, which now the priest is offering for us before Thy shrine. But soon the wood will make them His body and His blood. The sacrifice renewing once offered on the
Let us pray that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands with the praise and the glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church. O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For by your word you created the world and you governed all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son, you gather men and women, whom you made for the glory of your name, into one family, redeemed by the blood of his cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels, we proclaim your glory as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who always walked with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross in the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of the sacred mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all other bishops, with priests and deacons and your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church. As we thank you for the nourishment we have received in this Eucharist, we surrender ourselves into your hands and we pray that you may use us for your greater glory. Forgive us our many sins and bless our efforts that we make, even though they are of human weakness. Our efforts to love you, to serve you, to bring peace and joy in the world. We surrender into your hands the many people who have asked us to pray for them, especially those who are vulnerable and fighting this disease, and also those who are struggling because of a lack of resources. We pray very specially for expectant mothers, for those who have brought life in this world. We also lift up to you relationships that are falling apart and crumbling. Lord, may your healing strengthen them. And as we place ourselves into your hands, we pray that we may grow in a loving relationship with you and your Son, Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thy loving kindness is better than life. Thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise thee, thus will I bless thee. I will lift up my hands unto thy name. The skies are telling the glory of God. The skies are telling the glory of God. My lips shall praise thee, thus will I bless thee. I will lift up my hands unto thy name.